Namaste and welcome. I'm Dr. Rajiv Iyer, a pediatric anesthesia doctor. And in this video, I will tell you where is anesthesia injected during childbirth, and the fun begins now. You know there are two ways babies can come out. It's the normal vaginal delivery or through cesarean section. In this video, I'll just focus on the normal vaginal delivery. The anesthesia can be injected in three different places, either local anesthesia or intravenous sedative medicines or an injection in the back called epidural anesthesia. A particular person can be receiving only one of this or a combination of this. Now let's see what is injected in local anesthesia. During a normal vaginal delivery, there is a possibility that the normal vaginal hole may have to be extended in order for the baby to come out. This process is called episiotomy. In order to do this, there is a small cut which is made in the vagina. To achieve this in a pain-free situation, a pudendal nerve block or local infiltration is done in order to provide local anesthesia, and this injection happens around the vagina in the site where the pudendal nerve is, as you can see in this picture right next to me. Now the second option is the sedative medicines, which is actually injected through the intravenous line. Whether you end up having an intravenous sedation or not, you would still have an intravenous line placed in the labor suite just in case any additional medications is indicated. Now there are various different medicines that can be given through the intravenous route in order to ease some anxiety and also achieve some pain relief as a part of what is called as labor analgesia. Now the third option is called epidural anesthesia, which is an injection performed in the lower back, in the lumbar spine. In order to do this, the patient is usually made to sit up and sometimes turn to the side. After putting in local anesthesia in the back, an epidural needle is actually passed in. It goes into a space called an epidural space, and then a catheter is actually put in through which medicines can be either given continuously or intermittently in order to have pain relief during childbirth. In most cases, your anesthesia doctor will perform an epidural placement when the cervix is dilated somewhere between 4 to 5 centimeters, and sometimes it may be done early. During childbirth, for an anesthesia doctor, there are two precious people. One is the mother and the second is the baby or babies, if it's a twin or a triplet or whatever it is. Most people have a question, will I remember when all this is happening? The answer with these options that I mentioned, where you either take local anesthesia or sedation or epidural, yes, you would remember what is going on, although the pain would be significantly reduced with one or more of these options. Now, the labor can be very exhausting. For some people, it happens very quickly, but for others, it can be very painful without any of these options. Let me say this. It is not possible to generalize what is the best anesthesia, but it really depends on many factors, which will be clear once the doctor sees a patient. Now, providing labor analgesia is quite challenging for the anesthesia doctor because they have to make sure the mother actually has pain relief without making her sleepy or making the baby sleepy, and also be able to contract or push whenever she's asked to do so. Well, now you know where anesthesia is injected during normal childbirth. But what if someone is having cesarean section? Well, this is a topic for a different video. If you found any value, don't forget to hit that like button. If you're interested in videos related to anesthesia and operation, especially in children, make sure you subscribe to the channel so you get video updates whenever I release them. Take care, stay safe, and I'll talk to you soon.